Have you ever printed a color, checked your print, and noticed it turned out different than you expected? This is called color shift, and it will happen with every ink you print. Depending on a few key factors, you can end up with one color looking completely different than you anticipated. Let's look at the different variables at play and show you how to make adjustments to deal with color shift. To fully understand color shift, you have to understand how your eyes perceive color and the fundamentals of opacity. I highly recommend watching this video on how our eyes see color to get a better understanding of the science behind your eyes. Now that you understand how light affects the colors we see, how does opacity affect how we see color? Opacity is how well light can travel through an object. If something is 100% opaque, then you will not be able to see through it at all. This lid is considered very opaque because no light can move through it. Light will only reflect and absorb off of its surface. This bottle is not opaque. It is translucent. You can see right through it. Light travels through this bottle and back so that you can see things that are behind it. The more translucent something is, the more light is able to travel through an object, hit whatever is behind it, and reflect back. This makes ink color shift because it's being influenced by the t-shirt or base white underneath. To show you visually what color shift looks like, I'm going to print all of our FN ink colors on two shirts, one black shirt and one white shirt. Half the print will be printed on an underbase and the other half will be printed directly to fabric for a side-by-side comparison. Printing directly on a white t-shirt gives us the most accurate color to the bucket, so it makes for a great control print. Let's get printing. So you can see colors like the magenta and the navy are being strongly influenced by the base white and the t-shirt underneath the ink. When you print these more translucent inks on a base white, the color will become lighter than the bucket. This is because the base white is being seen through the ink. Light is moving through the magenta, hitting the white underneath, bouncing off of that base white and back to your eyes, making it appear lighter than your control print. If you print a low opacity ink directly on a black shirt, the color becomes more difficult to see, as seen here. The black shirt is being seen through the ink, just like the base white. But in this case, it makes the ink color appear darker because the light is being absorbed by the black underneath. So if you choose a low opacity color, like the magenta to be in your design, you'll have to work a lot harder to make sure it comes out looking the way you want it to. However, colors like fuchsia and light blue have a higher natural opacity. Even with the base white and black, there is still some color shift, but it is much less apparent than colors like the navy or magenta. There is not a lot of light moving through the high opacity ink to cause a dramatic color shift. All inks have a set natural opacity directly from the bucket. The ink's opacity is the main factor at play when it comes to how much an ink will color shift on press. So what makes an ink more or less opaque? Three things: the inclusion of white or black in the color, the manufacturers adding chemistry that helps to block light in the ink layer, and the inherent pigment qualities inside the ink. Because white reflects light and black absorbs light, the more black and white mixed inside the ink, the less light will be able to travel through, because it's either being reflected by the white or absorbed by the black. High opacity colors tend to be duller than the translucent colors due to this effect. If you want to learn about pigment qualities, there is a video in the description that goes into more detail about pigments and how it affects ink's opacity. So now that you see how an ink's opacity is correlated to color shift, how can we use this information to make adjustments? The sad part is there's no cut and dry way to make color adjustments. Every single ink color will have a different natural opacity. Even inks under the same brand or line of ink will have a different opacity. To say the least, it's a little complicated. You are going to have to test to figure out what you can and can't accomplish with your ink. The more that you understand the natural coverage of the inks you use, the better you will get at making educated guesses on how to make on-press adjustments. Here are some ways you can start to correct for color shift once you get to know your inks. When mixing Pantone colors, choose the Pantone color that's one shade darker in your Pantone book. This will make the color a little bit richer. The color will still shift a little bit lighter on your base white, but when you print, it will be closer to the color you were originally aiming for. Mesh count will also affect color shift. The higher your mesh count, the thinner your ink deposit is going to be, and the more translucent your ink will appear. If you're printing through a lower mesh count, you will end up with a thicker ink deposit. And that will be closer to the color in your bucket, but it may not match still. We recommend flashing your ink and then printing it again. Same thing with higher mesh counts. If you notice that the ink color is still not close enough to what you need, we recommend flashing it and printing the color again. And this will help you create the color that you need. If you are printing the same design across multiple colors, we suggest using a base white so the color shift is at the very least consistent throughout your different shirts. There will be a lot fewer variables when switching from garment to garment. Now, because there are so many variables at play here, the only way to get things the way you want is to make educated guesses, test them, and see if that works. Numerous times at my previous production jobs, this was the case. Even with over 20 years of experience in this industry, I'm still not always correct on my first couple of tries. Play around with the inks that you use. Experiment, because the more you know how inks behave on press, the less you will have to test. If you already use FN ink, then I already did some of the work for you. There are some videos by Windsor and Newton in the description for those who want more information on the complexities of ink opacity. In these videos, they're using acrylic paints, but the concepts are still the same for screen printing inks. Comment below if you have more questions, and we will do our best to answer them. I hope this helped you understand color shift at a deeper level. Like and subscribe if it did, and we will see you next time.